Hey, so I am so glad that you guys are here, but I wanted to recap. It is now the last week of 2021. And so what I wanted to go through with you guys is just a recap on the classes that I've taken and to really give you a idea of what I went through. And as you can see here, these are the four classes that I've taken. So for my first term, which started in May, okay, that class was a class in English composition. This was a fairly easy class, standard. There was nothing magnificent about this course, okay? As you can see, at that time, it was in software engineering. That was my major. Changed my majors a little bit later on, but you'll see that part. I went through and I changed it to a Bachelor's of Science in Cybersecurity. Okay, this was the one class, SC100, which was the Perspectives in Social Sciences. I absolutely loved this class. The instructor was really engaging. The content was engaging. You had to do a lot of going out to the internet, and there were YouTube videos, and there was just a lot of engagement in this class. It wasn't so dry, just a lot of book work. This was a really great class. When you get ready to go through this course, really easy. This is the document, by the way. What you're looking at is the document that you can give to your employer. I use this. They create it. It is inside of a special place within your SNHU. You are able to go in and you can do letters. So if your company does employee or tuition reimbursement, that type of thing, this is where you would come. You can give them this letter. And it will count and show, hey, you went to school from this time to this time. It shows what your major and your ID is. It also gives how much you paid. And if you didn't know, I pay each week. That's how I go to school. So I don't wait. This amount that you see here is what's billed. And what I do is I just break that down into a weekly payment. And I pay that every single week. I just send it like a regular bill, like you would do your electric or anything else. I just go through and do it. All right. This class, I'm sorry, I didn't really even talk about this class, but this class is intro to scripting. This was after having a conversation with my instructor. Initially in this class, I really struggled. This was not an easy class at first, and there's because you're going to have something called ZyBooks, and ZyBooks is really it's the school's like book that's interactive, gives you a lot of examples and teaches you how to do things. I really struggled at first with understanding how to work it. This class, as you can see, I got a B in the class. Not a big issue. That was in August and went until October. Okay, this class right here was the last class I just took, which was Intro to Structured Databases. Again, you're going to be using ZyBook. Again, you're going to be, this class doesn't have as many like posts where you're talking to students. It is only two actual things where you actually go in and physically talk to students. And so you can go through and see an idea of that. But this class got to be out of it. I know you guys, nobody cares about the grade, so to speak. It, you know, what did you learn from the course? This was a great course in understanding how to use SQL language. So if you don't understand how to use SQL, you can certainly go through. What I did is I took this course, and then I also went through and I took a course from Udemy. I have a course, and I'm not saying anything about it. This course for Udemy was really helpful in me getting through the course. If you are interested in taking something where you supplement your content that you get on the ZyBooks, because ZyBooks teaches one way. This was SQL and using MySQL, and when I finally started to use MySQL, it helped me to understand what I needed to do. And because they used Codeo, and Codeo looks more like, okay, Codeo is a, it looks like this. And so you're going to go through, and this is where you're going to do most of your class project. Is in Codeo, to me, was okay, but it really didn't go through like the stuff I really wanted to understand how to use. It did teach you, like, hey, look, this is what a lab environment is like, blah, 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 blah. And you're able to go through and do, you're able to go through and lay out stuff like this. And it's nice, and it gives the instructor an opportunity to see what you did. But for me, it was like, I just went through and used regular MySQL, and MySQL has a way of putting together things, and it allowed me to do so much more work and to understand what I was doing as opposed to using the Codeo. So that was my experience. But yeah, these are the four classes. Again, I started in May. We are now at the end of the year, and I am ready to go into the next set of classes. And my next set of classes is on app development. So that is a requirement for cybersecurity, is app development. But I just wanted to go through and share with you guys my experience and then be able to give you just a little bit of feedback on what's going on. So thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.